Hi there, I am Adam Kirbas, and this is my novel, The Accused. So I sat there, the jury, lost and outcast from the world. I was not lazy like the prosecution accused me of. No, dear jury, I could not work anymore. I could not go to work anymore and sell something. I could not chain in this notion that I would benefit this grand and great society. I didn't feel the strength anymore, because I did not know what to believe anymore. Maybe I was one of many. Maybe it is true. Maybe there were many like me, but I did not meet anyone. I sat there, all alone, in my room, lost in my own thoughts and abandoned from the world. This was my misery. This was my sorrow. And then I read in the newspapers, our villain has given a great party. All enjoy their lives in a great yacht. I read about it. And I saw these pictures. What American blood can buy. The furniture all was gilded in their private yachts. This is what we Americans bled for. And I endured it. I swallowed my pain. And the contrast, dear jury, me in my darkest hour, all alone. The electrician cut off the electricity because I could not afford the bill anymore. I did not have any running water, any gas, nothing. I sat in the cold and saw pictures of a world far away from mine. I thought about the misery I went through. All those useless moments I lived for. If I had known this would have come to that, if I had known where I would end, I don't know whether this life would have been worth living for. But I did not give up. I did not cave, dear jury. I did not pursue my single interest, not at all. I thought my life is already gone. I did not have anything to love in my life before. I had lost the only thing that was dire to me. No. I said to myself, America is not dead. America lives on. So I sat there, thinking. I wanted to bring about change. I wanted to do good. Me, a commoner. Me, someone who did not fulfill the American dream. Me, someone who had moral hindrances. Someone who had a moral conscience, who said, no, I will not shed American blood. I will not deceive good Americans. I was out of the ordinary. I was alien to a world which is led by egoism. So I sat there thinking. I walked through the streets. I saw people. I saw their fading smiles. Even joy does not mean anything at all. I saw people. People, despite hailing diversity, looking all the same. I saw people living in little boxes. Without any moral conscience, nothing. We were stripped out of bare humanity. While those others hail and cherish the downfall of our great grand society, we were left with nothing. Patriots could not hail anything. We could not hail our defeat. I could not applaud the fall of the greatest civilization on this earth. Who could have? Not no true American. All in vain. It was all in vain. Those who still raise the flag. I would ask myself, what for? These lives, they led to nothing and to nowhere. I walked the streets. The paths our ancestors walked. The thoughts, and maybe I tried to indulge in the thoughts of our ancestors. Maybe there I seek some bond beyond human comprehension, some bond to our past. But the only thing I felt were chains I was carrying through the streets. Chains which prevented the American heart from beating freely. Chains which dragged down our great society. And I walked through the streets, people. The American young were committing suicide. Stupid selfies. Stripped naked. Sharing their intimacy. But what for? Not to gain money. These people, they have even become less than prostitutes. No. They gave out their intimacy for free. They did not demand anything in exchange. No, they were even thankful that these villains, that these un-American and unpatriotic people gave them a platform to strip naked and share their intimacy with the world. This is what we commoners are good for. This is the common American heart, which is just exactly to do this. To do that. All in vain. It was all in vain. And these people, they all lived for a purpose. for a purpose to give up themselves for this great business. And they were even thankful to the greatest villain of our time. They were thanking him. Oh dear, oh dear. What would our lives be without this great invention, without a platform where we can strip naked and give away our humanity so that we become all the same, all but puppets, all but cash cows, prostitutes, humans without life, zombies. And everyone thought they were living the American dream. Everyone thought this is freedom, pure freedom, that we would be above all others. I did not see people happy. Because we think freedom supposed to be about happiness, about joy, that we enjoy our lives, and that we Americans at the pinnacle of all civilizations, that we should be damn happy. That every American who gets up in the morning should be proud, joyous, and happy. Because he is free. But I did not see joyous faces. I did not see happy faces. I did not see proud Americans who were proud of who they are. No, I saw miserable wretches, people having become mentally anorexic, people who are worn out, mental fret bars, who walk the streets. These are the people I saw. There was no joy in his freedom because we did not get anything in return. There is no joy in such a life where you just give your intimacy, give your identity, give away who you are and do not get anything. You surrender America just for a mouse click, just for a love you may get from some people who hate America, who tell us that we should be miserable for who we are, people who tell us that we should not be proud of everything our fathers and forefathers have accomplished, that we should throw everything into the ditch because it means nothing no more. It means nothing in a world which has put values on their head. A world which has no moral values, not at all, nothing, but hails a void, hails superficiality. This has become the new God. This has become the new American God. Praise yourself. Put yourself above all others. I saw people who did not smile, who did not enjoy their lives, one step away from suicide. We have become a suicide society. And I felt the loss of everyone. I felt their pain. I felt the gut-wrenching pain. And I felt their hopelessness. Like I felt the same feeling when I sat in the dark, when I thought you cannot change it, you cannot bring about change. When I saw those wealthy people, those un-American, who feast on American blood. When I saw how far they came, I cannot change anything. I cannot bring about any change, despite my ancestors having been great revolutionaries, despite they having fought for their freedom, having put into place a great constitution. But I, as their descendants, I was meek, hopeless, and I saw many of us on the streets, wandering somewhere, going nowhere, having no past and having no future. I saw people who are nothing but the shadow of our great ancestors, because they do not commemorate the past anymore, because it is thrown into the ditch. It has become muddy and not worth saving for. I saw people who were miserable, and this, dear jury, was the second time in my life when I wept. I wept bitterly when I lost the love of my life, because I knew I won't be happy ever again, because this is what meant for me true happiness: to find a girl you love, to be with someone you love. And the second time I wept was because I did not see hope. I did not see a possibility how we could change anything, how we could bring about change. I knew we had to change something. I knew that we had to do something, because America was drowning. I stood at the ruins of our great society, but I could not prevent it from drowning. I could not prevent this grand society, my love blood, being sucked out of me. I could not prevent America from dying, this great idea, our freedom we have surrendered for people who celebrate the end of our society on a yacht, paid by the blood of decent people. And this left me stranded. Days passed by. I did not know what to do, because I was all alone, because it was only me. There are many Americans who think like that, who think like me. But we are scared to open our mouths. We are scared to express our discomfort, because values have changed. Society has been put to its head. Now it is called un-American to cherish your past, to cherish your history, to commemorate great events, to hail freedom. We do not hail, we Americans do not hail a king. We do not hail one person, one tyrant, one individual. We hail something dire, something that money cannot buy. And this is our freedom. This is who we are. So I walked these streets all alone. All alone. I saw these people, but I could not talk to them. Dear jury, this was not the moment when I decided to take action. At least not violent. I'm not a violent person. I never thought about going and killing people. This is not what I am. I'm not an animal. I believe in justice. I believe in the rule of law. I believe in what I was taught. What I supposed to hail. And I'm a brainchild from my forefathers. I wanted to encourage people to be who they are. To do not feel ashamed. And to push back this menace, which this poison, which destroys our society from within. I stood on those streets, on those very streets, with flyers in my hand, giving it to every passerby, handing out the little I knew, the little I saw. I didn't do it for myself. I did it for the people I love. I did it for the great society I am part of and for this great country I adore. I love the history which is alive through all our veins. I stood there handing out flyers stating America is not dead. The idea lives on and will live on as long as we believe, as long as we keep fighting. But people would not listen. And dear jury, I tried everything. I held speeches. I stood in front of people. Said, dear Americans, my fellow Americans, we are being deceived. We are being robbed of our identities. My fellow Americans, we are losing our faith. We are losing everything what we are proud of. Wake up. Raise yourself. Don't give in. I did not found any listeners. I didn't find any listeners. People just laughed at me, walked past me. They did not know anything at all. Because for them, I was an alien. I was someone outside the world, outside their comprehension. And I felt so much heart pain, de jure, because I could not help it. I could not convince people that we are losing something dire, that this is a dark path we are on. And I said to myself that good patriots, people who deeply care for their country, they defend it. It is being American is not just about raising your flag and singing our great anthem. It is as well as defending your country. And it was a defense, dear jury. I did not attack anyone. I did not fight anyone. I defended America. I defended the idea. I defended our freedom. There is no court in this world. No trial in this on God's soil, which can accuse me of being a traitor to my country. If I be wrong, then only God above can judge me. No human, because I care for America, because I care for our people, and I shed my blood for it, I shed my sweat for it, and I want that America, that future generations of Americans experience the way America is today. Does not and do not grow up in a society which is debauched, depraved to its core, rotten and wicked. I saw that the end was nigh. I saw in front of us the abyss where we are heading to full speed. And I tried to hit the brakes. I tried to stop this from happening. As the good patriot I am, I could not let it go. I could not walk past it. I do care about America because I love America. But where was the solution? Where I wanted to uproot all evil. I wanted to save the soul of our people. And I thought about it. And I thought about it very carefully. Who is the cause of it all? Who does not love America? Who does not want the good of our people? And who celebrates the death of this great nation? And the answer was clear. The answer was all over the news, on every corner, in every human's minds. The answer was the disease, which spread quickly among our people. The new dawn, the new age, the new generation, as it was praised by ingenious PR agents. I knew